Hello everyone, bonjour à tous, and welcome back to part 23 of the Star Stable. That's fine. So we're going into the game here. So I'm not going to talk about this. I was thinking to myself, I want to continue the game story quest because we're here in front of a dark corporage captain. There's a ship, and this dark corporage is going to be about the last time. So I think we should go ahead and do that. I think Audrey's going to knock her out. Hopefully that's too loud. Okay. So, let's go to the top of this dark cloud. Can you see what he has to say? There you are, so I'm the fossil transporter. Good. Put it in a container box with 10 minutes down to the industry. And get the fossil on board. Looks like the stone is going to act as a decoy. Okay, I was going to say first stone. We'll see you soon, I hope. Okay. I can talk to him. This looks like a poor stone. That's a bad. Okay, what I was thinking to you, I just need to wrap up this up here. Goodbye, kiddo. I'm back from that. I'm staying right here. Away. Away with you. Okay, this looks like we need to sneak on. The barge as well, or the stowaway of the company, maybe? Oh, and a fridge. Okay. Behind this fridge. Interesting choice. Okay, and there's Captain Venus inconspicuously watching. Okay, we're just gonna put down. We've made it. We got onto the barge. Okay, behind the fissures of the barge and barge. Probably seems like the barge has been just fine to sleep. We didn't. Have some water with us, maybe some snacks. Okay, that place looks very nice. Like an actual earthquake and like a video. I don't think we should have a more compact video of all these extra platforms. Okay, do you want this in the panel? Okay, what do we have to do? Continue transforming. So that's it. Okay, stone is rather than taking some else on the dark part. Okay, so I guess we can save stone. We can find more stone. We have to try and look at just one. Don't get caught. I guess. Let's see if we can. Let's see. I like the vibe though. Oh, not the vibe, but like the colors, like the lighting, it's very like cyberpunk. Okay, let's see. I think there's some guards. We can hide behind some lights. Let's just test it. Okay, so it's like a crouch. Hide. Not spotted. So this guy turned around, and I guess I'll go ahead and carry this in. They can't see us crouch from behind a box like that. Could be careful to this one. I think so. Okay, here we go. I wonder if just like the dark cards have like some kind of like Philosophical quandaries of the common student in Starbucks, because they're all clients. How do you feel about that? You have no sense of identity. Because they're all clients of each other. Spot you get teleported back to like the beginning of this area. So that you can call here. Okay, this is a dead end. What do we have to do? Rinse bean and Justin. We found Ghost of Horse and Justin. Justin's having a conversation. Okay, we're dancing. And Rinse bean indicating parts of this conversation. Okay, Justin, what do you mean this is not your horse? I don't understand. There must have been some sort of mix up. The thing I'm sure is that it isn't my horse. Unless it was Leopard Dirks's either. Something which Pi was supposed to have endowed it with. That's just an ordinary nag. You know, I can't remember what horse I would add. Is it sick? That horse is full of power. It's not sick, but that's not something. There's something fishy about it. I can feel its power, but it's not the kind we expected. It's ridiculous. All the money we spent on which Pi, and she trusts it with some sense of that. Wait, I don't think Pi treats us. She's been a faithful servant. I love dark horses several times before. You don't betray to the core, you just don't. It's been some sort of mix up, and we have to find out what it is and fast. This isn't good. This horse was familiar somehow. I just can't quite place it. My memory is a bit hazy. I must have seen it before, but when? She joined us and saw things from the right side, that is, the dark side. Joined the dark side. We have found something in the past, but it's going to be alright, my grandson. It's going to be alright. Probably nothing important was wondered anyways. Ahem. Cough, cough. Not only are we missing a dark horse for Justin, we still don't have the perfect candidate for the fourth and final dark rider. Especially four of us. It has to be before those darn druids have time to gather their four silly soul riders. Calm down, Jessica. Just calm down. We might spider on Silverblade and find a shred of evidence that they're on the track of either Lisa or Anne. But they got the window, didn't they? I can make her disappear as elegantly as I did Lisa and Anne. Ha ha. More or less. If it wasn't that newcomer, Linda would still be away somewhere. What would her name again? That horse girl who came to Moreland. Felicia, now I remember, and that horse is hers. It's stone. Uh-oh. I can sense it interferes in the dark force. Okay, it smells like druid. Look, who's that lurking behind the curtains? I knew I could sense someone's presence. That's Felicia. Get her. What do you want, to rescue you? I don't want to be rescued. Get out. Just get out of here, Felicia. Try my grandfather to bring the dark side. Get away from here now. Okay, who else thinks this is inspired by... Now, okay, so it looks like we need to run with stone. Okay, gotta get out of here faster, increase lightning. I'll have to be with our children's time. Keep the distress player ready. When we get outside, we'll see you in a good spot. We got a ruse, we'll come around to this boat and pick you up. Okay. So looks like we need to escape. Here. Stone. Okay. This reminds me of like a parking lot. Parking garage with many floors. Okay, alright. This is a little... safe. Okay, perfect spot. Is it here? Okay. And we continue going down, I suppose. Right. Oh, we almost fell down. Oh, we fell. Games are not very well made for horses. Okay, here we go. Alright. Perfect time to catch a Bruce. Oh. Alright. Okay, you escaped. After the boat ride, you land on the Mormon South Beach. Captain Bruce goes on to Cape West Fishing Village. I think Captain Bruce's ship was still a bit overkill, but, I mean, it worked in the end. Alright. Here's Alex. You're back. Tell me about your adventure. When adventure you've had, I'm so impressed by your heroics and Stone's bravery, some Mr. Sands, and two of his dark guardians live out there on the oil rig. Shows us the secret Dark Corps headquarters. You're saying that Justin made it clear that he didn't want to come back with you. Maybe he had no choice. What have we learned from this? That's true. We have confirmed that Dark Corps is somehow responsible for Lisa and Anne's disappearance. We know that they want to stop us from gathering four soul riders. We also know that they're trying to get four Dark Riders and they're in a hurry. And that Justin is one of the four now. We need to wrap our heads around this one. Our next step must be planned well. We need to discuss this with Rip and the other druids, Ollie and I. You can inform us about the details, and maybe get started as soon as possible. Okay, so we need to ride up to Vildale, talk to Elizabeth about what we found out. Oh, circle. Recyclable. Okay, let's get going. One here. There's like an invisible boulder or something. Okay. Alright. Oh my goodness. Okay, invisible obstacle. here. Delayed dragon tree. Okay. Right, and I wonder if I'll have to go back to the silver clay library again to research with Linda, or if the main story quest will have us end up in Failed Hills. Then we'll just continue with quests from there. Like, I guess we can do those and go to Failed Hill Lake and then progress after that. Any jute? Oh, I don't like it today. Not today. Admire the river. And the sky. Alright. Where's our lone tree? As we're riding towards, oh, there it is. We're riding towards Valdale, we can see like a single tree along the mountain range. Just standing guard, standing sentinel. All by itself. There it is. Okay. Almost there. Also talk to Farrah, see if she has information for us about her business. Okay. Here we go. Okay, here. Elizabeth, what do you have for us today? What news? As death, we shall have all the hardships you have endured, the poor information you have managed to discover. The druid meeting has to take place immediately, right up to the spiral shaped path, and follow in clockwise direction to get to the druid meeting through the portal, just like last time you went there. Alright. Set up to the druid school. To manifest. Okay. Here we are. Let's hope that there isn't a bug like last time. Time, space, merge. Everything is calm. Always in motion. Okay. Script together again, the druids and soul riders, travel times, call for desert measures. I've just informed of the news Felicia has brought forth from the breaking adventures. Quite a few issues that need our careful consideration. Because quite a question is such a strong leading sight to Skeptical Hill, things have happened, the shadow witches could easily have catched Felicia and devoured her soul, the reign of the shadows. Don't be silly, the fact that Felicia possesses such power is in fact a blessing. Brickring makes her ears hurt. She had no choice but to find the apple of loneliness, and she succeeded. Some of the powers of Felicia possesses should also be controlled and must prioritize her training. Now, however, we have one matter to discuss. Let us review the facts one more time. Alex, please give us a summary. Sure, Brett, another justice in the Dark Horse secret headquarters, which has been built in some kind of oil rig south of the lake. We should overhear a discussion between Mr. Sands, two Dark Riders, and Justin. Saying they had been fooled out of Justin's horse, which, as we know now, is supposed to be a Dark Rider horse. Justin, in fact. So Justin is a Dark Rider now. Yes, he thinks I'm making another forward less early yet, but he is not there against his will. He did not want to rescue by Felicia. I don't know if he felt pressure to say that once, but Felicia would not get caught. Felicia heard rumors that Mr. Sands has manipulated Justin's memories. We're not sure if it's Justin's own choice, but he don't know. Okay, so hope for Justin is not lost. Maybe not. I'll continue. Before Felicia is forced to run away head over heels, Sharon said that there was a four dark riders and looking at this and wanted to be able to do what needs to be done. Whatever it is that needs to be done, it has to be done before the soul riders beat them to it. What is it that Dark Knight wants to accomplish with the four dark riders before they do this thing which we have no idea what it is? Please, Felicia has already figured it out. I have. Yes, Felicia's gone to terrible conclusions. Dark Knight is going to try and speed up the efforts to summon Garnock, assisted by their dark riders. Who's Garnock again? Do you guys remember? Wasn't there like a volcano of Garnock or something that Conrad was talking about? That's impossible. Unfortunately, it may very well be possible. Soul Riders' primary duty is to fight Garnock, and we should Dark Riders in the opposite and any way to our Soul Riders must have some connection to Garnock. Dark Core's secret agenda has always been to strengthen Garnock, control the power to rule the world, and this for quite some time. There's nothing that indicates that this is no longer true. It's too likely for us to take a chance and move along with the plan. It definitely explains why Mr. Sands is back again. This is somewhat of an expert in this area. Must have come to something new to have come back to work again. Especially after what happened last time. Giggles. What? What do you mean, Frip? Giggles. The Lost Light Ceremony Book. Mr. Sands has found the Lost Light Ceremony Book, the book that describes how the Soul Riders perform by the ceremony to stop Garnock. Oh no, I think Bert and Doggy took it. Mr. Sands has found the book. In that case, he and his Dark Riders could run the ceremony backwards and make Garnock stronger. This is the case because one of these two fragile walls keep Garnock beyond the right number of reality. Goodness gracious, what audience might be with us if everything's lost if Mr. Sands succeeds? I don't know if it's that bad yet. That's right, let's hope we've got it all wrong. For friends, we don't seem to be wrong, we must act accordingly. We need to act, we need to gather our Soul Riders. We still don't have any good leads on locating Lisa Nan. Information comes from Felicia. Felicia confirms that Dark Corwin is behind the disappearances. Can we find out any more information? Also, we need to start on training Felicia, so she can be a real Soul Rider. Who knows when we're going to find this man? We need alternative plans. What should we do now? Is there anything else we can do to interfere with the Dark Corwin even more? If they think we should plan another visit to Dark Corwin, they must be a little slower if they're one Dark Rider and one horse short. Just imagine if we had just enough, or if we find the False Life Ceremony book of Mr. Sands and have us in his position. Because without saying that going back is dangerous to take, it may be worth it to be able to get some more important information. Let's finish the meeting now, so we're using our planning. We have gained some time until they find any words for Justin. This is definitely responsible to make sure that we should get as much training as possible before we decide on our next course of action. So you can see, go in peace, druids, and survivors. Okay. Alright, so that's an interesting update. Looks like we are going to have to do some more investigation work to foil Mr. Sands' plans to bring back Garnock, which I guess is like the evil force in your. There's a lot to discuss, and all of it was important. I know a lot more now than I did before, thanks to you. We're short of time, there's a constant threat of darkness in the shape of Garnock, but the next move needs to be planned well. We will move on with next step. We're ready for it. Now we need to plan and prepare so next step produces the result we want. The situation is as bad as we think. One wrong move, and Dark Claw might well succeed with their evil plan. Grip thinks we should begin to get ready for a new expedition to Dark Horse headquarters to find out more about their plans. I'll contact you when we're ready to go on. Okay, that looks like. We need to wait, and the next section is going to be with James. Interesting. Okay, so let's continue with some side quests around Valedale. So let's keep going with the quests around Galdo here. So let's see what else Elizabeth has for us. Valley doesn't appear on any normal maps, but we druids know there's land of magic wonders. And that wall of ice has been there since anyone has traveled there. I'd like to see it again. ride up to the mountain pass and see if you can get through. I wonder if this is going to be what unlocks it, or if we have to take a couple more turns. I don't remember honestly how long it takes. Doesn't look like it. The snow melted. Oh. Okay. Looks like we might be able to get through. Interesting. I wasn't expecting that. I thought it might take a little more time. Oh, I thought it would be alright. The sun has been shining so fiercely as of late, beating down on the icy face of the mountain. Tell the intention of open, you're free to explore, so please. Many precious artifacts have been locked over so long, but now it joins confused together the enigmatic history of this island. I wish I can't thank you enough for what you have done. So I'm just being cautious, we know very little of what has been hiding behind that wall of ice for so long. Ride out and seek safe passage into the valley, I will remain here. But the valley itself is highly isolated, which means that stables and other menus will not be available. Considering the feat it was to enter, it may just be as difficult to get out. Go prepare yourself before you enter the icy valley. Okay, so it looks like we need to ride out. In the valley is where you introduce the archaeology, which you eventually get to Epona. You can make a lot of money now, like a significant amount of shillings to engage archaeology. So, okay, so we're gonna ride through this passage. The elevator hasn't been used for 100 years, it's not useful. Okay, so maybe we're gonna fix it somehow. Frozen Valley Peak of Freezing Mist spreads up beneath the old elevator. And the valley of the dinosaur. The elevator really looks as though it's possible to get down along the mountainside here. There's platforms along the mountainside, and because the elevator holds a very long step in them, I need to get down without stopping. No, but to come back at the same night, it's still so risky. You gotta do what you gotta do, I'm an adventure. I can find another way there. Until then, I'm alone, I have nobody to help me. The drama. Okay, looks like I'm gonna go down the side of the mountain using the ice platforms. Oh, okay, they do break into small pieces. Oh no. Okay, you weren't quick enough. Let's try that again. Okay, let's build up some speed. Oh my goodness. Okay, we almost fell off. Alright, come on, stone. More platforms here. Okay, I think that might be the end of it. More ice platforms, yes. Okay. Here we go. The elevator shafts are section. You're on here now. Part of the other shop, and it just seems unusable from down here as it is from up there. The elevator's right through here, there, and the elevator structure, the last section, you can check it out and see if it's possible to fix it. If I can fix the elevator, I can show where you'd like to fail down, and this can come with me to the valley of the hidden dinosaur without risking death on the dangerous mountainside. Okay, but But it was okay for us to risk death on the dangerous one side. Okay, let's see if we can fix the engine. Okay. Not sure if they saved our dates, broken, rusty, not a fuel. Was in better condition, since then we started using some other device. Which must be somewhere nearby. Definitely that's just the kind of controller I need to check it out. What's interesting is that there's still a light on in the control room. Go over the door. Which means that somebody must be using it, right? If that hasn't been used in 100 years. Door is padlocked and I can't get in. Okay. And if there's a key hidden around here somewhere, around the door thing, and a window maybe, maybe the old classic upturned flower pot. I don't look, I really want to get to this little building. So I'm looking for a key around the building. And about this draft here. Okay, found the key. So let's go ahead and open the door. Yes, the key fits the lock. The door's open now. Right? It's the control of the elevator. The control panel looks so old. The building was carved with an engineering from the late 19th century. The late 19th, so that would be the late 1800s. Definitely needs a closer look to see how messed up the control panel is. Okay, so we're examining. The panel looks pretty intact, even though it's not been used for 100 years. The building seems to have protected all the delicate machinery from the wind and weather. So we can find this one here. It could be a spare part. So I think we can actually fix this motor. We can find this whole field. I can get the elevator started. I really feel like I need to find a safe way to travel between the field here. It's an amazing and exciting valley. Only then can Elizabeth come here with me. Let's look at the key. I know there's a few odds and ends broken up in the snow. There could be things on the level of the plate. I could use the spare parts. Are you sure? Plus, I think I might have seen a diesel canister here somewhere outside the store. Okay, so it looks like we're gonna find. We need to fix the engine in the snow, which is very. What's the word I'm looking for? Serendipitous. Very lucky. So we found an old jar, an old piece of metal. And some kind of mechanical part. Okay, old metal scrap. Looks like we're finding multiples of everything. Okay, so we've had two of each. Apparently this is going to fix, and this will be a bit of a lag. Tag bunch of spare parts, what's the junk? I guess I'll make these for a basic repair, though. To be sure, the motor can be fixed, even with these random bits of garbage. So I'll toolbox the control of someplace, I'll need that while I'm doing my repairs. Okay, so I'm going to go grab the toolbox. Multiple times. stuck on stone. This is not good. Okay, apparently we can fix from up here. Okay, looks like we're repurposing the scrap metal that we found. So I wonder where we learned all this mechanical knowledge. Okay, done. Now this is something for now, at least. Okay, but we're stuck on stone. Okay, here we go. Alright, let's see if we can get some fuel. The tank still has kind of diesel. It's got to be a can of utility, some kind of somewhere in the snow. And I can fill with diesel. So I can fill the fuel tank and get the water going. And hunting again for a fuel can. Okay, so found it. Nice. Alright, let's cut off, get another one in. Fuel tanks have up loads of really old diesel. I'll try starting the other the control panel and the control room. Okay, go back to the shed. Try and start the elevator. Okay, a little start again. Okay, time. The old elevator is dead. Wait. Oh, okay. Oh, we already started it. Let's talk to the question mark. Or the question mark. It works for how long? Last question. Probably not entirely. That was dry. Right? Look at the old elevator. Okay. Now, do we go fetch the equipment? No, I don't know what's working. Okay, the elevator is fine. Come on, Stella, let's go. Let's run around here all day. Okay, so we're going to go in the elevator, see what works. Oh, I need to get the horse. Okay. So ride in the elevator to make sure we feel safe and wait in one piece. Lucky hostile should stay hopeful that last long enough because the family lifts up and down. The goodness is moved pretty fairly between Galvia and the valley. Oop. Everyone can go to the ancient valley unless they're afraid of elevators, of course. Time to tell us about the good news that the elevator is working. Stones get out of here before your hooves freeze fast to the ground. Good. Let's go back to this. That say 9 shillings was the reward. I don't understand when they do like random odd amounts like that. Going up to stick to increments of 5. Okay. I'm going to deliver the good news. Hello, Stone's cousin. Let's wave. Let's wave to Stone's cousin. Okay. Hello, Felicia. Hello, Stone. This is the elevator back in business. I thought I could hear something going on up on the mountainside. This is a little thing to say to traveling. Well, I have a few things prepared for today. Probably best to wait until tomorrow. We can't wait that long, can we? There are things in the valley I really, really want. I'll get everything together right away and we can get the valley's nails later. While I do that, you can ask Avalon if something in particular he wants to bring back from the valley, okay? Okay, talk to Avalon in the village. We'll meet you at the elevator. separate time. Go straight down to the valley with Elizabeth. Check in with Avalon to see if he needs anything. Guessing there might be like her ingredients or something that he's in his druid business research. Hello, Felicia. The personal valley is open again. Interesting. Very interesting. Elizabeth wonders if I want something from there. Very interesting. I need ice and thistles. They grow in the valley. They grow in the valley. The hidden dinosaur are long gone. She's a bird. Okay. Fantastic plant. All kinds of properties that don't exist in any other plant in the world. Very interesting plant. If you ask me. Off to go and meet Elizabeth and let her know I want ice and thistles. Okay. This is interesting. Okay. Oops. Roses growing along the river break. Which I think wouldn't happen naturally because roses are very picky as a flower. Like they require a lot of care and maintenance. Oh, right, we have to. Oh, of course, she's already waiting at the elevator. I guess if we have time, we'll do more side quests with Avalon. Hopefully we can fix the green water, the clear water that's being caused by those dark core goons. Alright. Where was Elizabeth? Did she already go down? She went down without us. Okay. I was like, who's that? That's another player. Tomoko Woolcraft. Oh, she's also Stone's cousin. That's the same starting model as Stone, with a different mane and tail color. Dressed very well for the weather, did she? I said this also, I thought it was a very interesting plant, you know. This place, wow, it's so cool, right? Cold. It's kind of unnerving cold, don't you think? Do you feel it? I've never been this cold in my life. Since saying cold actually has explanations, but the meteorological and historical lectures can be for another time. No need to get to work, for everyone hears about how the valley is accessible. Okay, they'll swarm here, traveling all over everything, and unnerving the world. Some kind of blue-eyes crystals and thousand dinosaurs. If you find some, they're clearly rare, possess mystical powers. They're called calstones. I really want to examine them much more closely. Like I said, they're secret rares, so there's a chance you might need to look for a while. Okay, let's see if we can get the ice thistles at the same time. Go around and gather ice thistles from the Avalon. They're shaded from here and there, but hurry up these notes while the explorers come inside them or stamp all over them. They're so valuable. This is what we have on them, so let's gather a proper bunch. Pick a dozen. Okay, looks like we're gathering any objects. Okay, so we got one. I think this one. Oh, that's pretty. It looks like it's, like the bee ball, but it's just, light blue instead. Okay, we got a cowstone. Third ice-thistle. Fourth ice-thistle. Tongue twister. And fifth ice-thistle. Sixth ice-thistle. Seventh ice-thistle. Eighth. Ice and thistle. 9th ice and thistle. 10th ice and thistle. Okay, and our second cowstone. 8th. And the 11th ice and thistle. There's going to be the last cowstone. Up here. Back here somewhere. Oh, I should have done that. I should have picked all those. This one's going to show me the last location of the last cowstone. Which one is back here? Okay, my goodness. Alright, we've got our third cowstone. Let's bring these back to us. Oh, we're into the rock kind of process. Very good. Thank you for the shot, beautiful examples you found. Maybe they're not quite so rare after all. Great. Do you hear that? Tell me a little bit. It's full of huge amounts of energy. So exciting. Thanks, beautiful specimens of ice and thistles. Okay, let's see what else. Right on the floor, we're going to like this is to come back. Let me know how it looks at the end of the road. So earlier, but there's like a blocker doesn't want it to proceed any further, so maybe Elizabeth has an idea of how to clear the way. Maybe Agnetha has a flamethrower we could borrow. Except for chainsaw. Okay, the road is blocked with snow and ice, but another player just ran through. Because I guess they've unlocked this part of the map. Alrighty. I'm looking forward to when SSO updates this area because I'm sure they can make it look really cool. Oh, not that far. Up to snow and ice, you say. We're not going to wait around for that little blocking ice to melt. Nothing melts here. Let's help this break time around in a more explosive way. Okay, we're going to blow stuff up. Try to find small pieces of cowstone so we can use them to explode whatever's blocking the road. Collect these small cowstones and I'll meet you down by the end of the road. Okay, so explode things. Very nice. Exciting. Okay. So we have one small cowstone. There's a second piece. Two small cowstones. Okay, there's a third one. And three small cowstones. Alright, let's go with Elizabeth. Five block portion of the row. Blow some stuff up. That'll look perfect. Beautiful cast stones, that should do the trick. Take the little pile of cast stones and place them on the ground by the ice blockage. We'll back off a little and take shelter behind the log before we set fire to the cast stones. You have the honor of doing it if you'd like. Here, take this room staff and you don't back it up to cover. Use the staff and concentrate all the magical power to set fire to the little pile of cowstones. Then, if my calculations are right, it should hopefully be a case of bang, and the ice is gone. Oh, looks like we're gonna get a trench coat as a reward. Nice. Alright. Okay, so we need to take cover. We can't just blast them from here. Encouraging safety. Okay, so we can't do this while mounted. That's very strong. Aim over the log. Alright. Shwabam! Nice. Kaboom! Okay. Success. Fire and ice. Aha, fantastic. Two good things start with a little explosion. Hopefully noise don't start any avalanches. Anyway, now that one has got it for you, carry on now and find it where it leads. Go find Jason, the whole valley's in dinosaur, and go and head back to the other. Take a look at the treasure so you have it close. Good luck now, you're strong for me. Come to the making sometime soon. You can tell me about your adventures in the valley. Okay, so we got a trench coat that looks like a dress. Oh, I do like the dresses. In the closet, and I'm never going to look at it again. Like, ever. Like they need to, if necessary, we'll just update them so that they look a little nicer, maybe. I don't know. They're just not to my taste. I feel like it would be impractical to ride around in a dress unless it's got like split skirts that's meant for riding. Okay, what do we have here? Okay, interesting. Hello there, it's me, Nick. Oh my word, real life person, caricature. You're real. You're really real. Haven't seen another one this long in ages. Ha ha ha. Finally, someone to talk to. And it's not enough just some random either. Brr, it's you who held out for me to get Mama my balloon going from everyone in the fields, wasn't it? Yes, we did help him. Okay, we meet again. Felicia, of course, that's your name. And who's this handsome fella here? Stone, say. Okay. Can't say I really recognized your horse right away. The most important thing is that you're here. Okay, I hope the stuttering is not annoying. Oh, I'm stuttering. It's freezing. Brr. Okay, see if we can help get a fire started, maybe. Brr, my main goal to learn expedition is to be able to find a secret place. I've been looking for my whole life, and I started to get indications that that place in question was in and around the valley of the hidden dinosaur. The journey, unfortunately, in the chaos, I flew straight to the north of the mountain. The plan came about the southwest, the lake took a straight up course. This thick white mist made it impossible to see anything. The caves, I thought through the gaps in the clouds. I could see from one magical place on the ground. I felt warmth in my heart and tried to steer the thing towards it. But the combination of my sentry and steering and the cold hard winds meant that I seemed less controlled and heading straight back down to earth. In a panic, I chose some more sandbags and dumped all my equipment off the side of the cliff, but it was no use. I smashed right down the sea, and now suddenly everything was white. Brr. When I came up, I realized I was totally alone and abandoned and totally non-scared here in the valley of the dinosaurs. Lost, I hadn't been able to crush them, but it's simply too dangerous to work on foot without any equipment. Can you imagine how tired, hungry, cold, exhausted I am? Looks like he didn't pack the correct winter clothes either. Just trying to get the balloon to stop the heavy boat again. I had to throw a load of heavy boat overboard. It's probably lying in winter, summer, possibly covered in the snow. It never stops falling. If you can, another strong horse, please help me find my lost equipment to get out of the ground and bring it back to me. Be amazing, I'm partially exhausted, able to carry anything, and my limbs are so stiff and frozen I can barely burn. Okay. Let's see if we can do the quest at the same time. I finished all the sandbags that I had as a ballast. I was trying to get this quest. Could you look for them as well after I make them? Thanks, Alicia. Burr. Okay, go searching for his equipment and sandbags. Looks like we found one side bag. Okay, we found one equipment box. Okay, two sandbags. Three sandbags. Okay, found a second equipment box. Okay, a third equipment box. Fourth equipment box. Okay, fourth sandbag. Sandbag. Sixth sandbag. Seventh sandbag. And the fifth equipment box. And the eighth sandbag. Okay. Did you look at that? My wonderful old intricate backward belongs. Thanks. Thanks, Brenner. Here's to Moko again. Amongst all my adventure thief, there should be a tent that I've had with my most different expeditions and adventures. Please be able to put it up so I have a safe place to sleep to shelter. It's been amongst these four adventures until now, I believe, and it's been really very cold. Far too frozen to be able to put the tent up myself. She helped me with a pretty complicated tent. Wow. But I think we can match. So we'll put this down. Probably, oh, we don't need to get off stone. Okay. Interesting. Okay, they'll attend from horseback. Take out, see, the tent is up, and let's get a decent night's rest. Okay, it looks like we can also potentially sleep here if we so wished. It's so cold, gray and dark here. Can you help me walk the lantern out of snow so that I can choke this candle I have in the wind? But we'll go out, go just here in front of me so that I can wipe my hands and get a little light. I should eventually be up to the belt on myself. It's pretty much like a snow lantern. It's an interesting concept. Okay, just mounted. More snowballs. I need a few. Maybe four or five or six. Oh, this structure doesn't look very regular. Don't have much confidence. Okay. Maybe eight. Or night. Okay, keep going. Make a tower of snowballs. Okay, there we go. Haha, lovely. That's how we keep the candle going out. Now it just needs to be lit. Okay, I suppose we're gonna do that as well. Here, to take my lighter and light the candle and the snow lanterns so I can get a little warmth and stop shaking. Let's see if this works. Oh, so now don't put your face in it. Thanks, Alicia, for the warmth spreading through my body. It's going to clear up my head. The rest of the shape seem to be over now. Just from that little tiny fire? Okay. No, that's no good. Brr, I think we need to get bigger than just a little snow lantern. Proper campfire. Yep, that's what we need. Can you run out and get some firewood from the forest? We're doing good. I'll build a fireplace, set a stone circle, set the fire doesn't blow away in the wind. Okay. Pick up some firewood nearby. Okay, so we have one branch, two branches, three branches, four branches, just need a fifth. Five branches. Eight. Three firewood frozen. We'll probably be able to set fire to it to see what lovely campfire prepared for us. Brr. Brr, my fingers are still so fairly frozen. I can't even use my lighter. Would you want to support this campfire, please, Felicia? Okay. Do we need to dismount for this again? We need to dismount to use fire. Am I too close? Sometimes, like, the appropriate, like, place to place your mouse is not very obvious. The campfire, always run the warm up. Nothing has caused me to like it. The flickering light of the campfire. Which I agree. Like, if you've ever been camping, if you have a bonfire in your backyard, or on the beach, it's really nice. Right now, I'm something to support the sleepless food. I'm super hungry and wouldn't mind a little help with filling the stand over the campfire. I can hang up this cauldron and let the fire put the food where I need. Can you have a look around for three long sturdy sticks and set them together to form a stand over the campfire? The name of this adventure cauldron. Hehe. Okay, he has an adventure cauldron. It's kind of funny. Alright, three long 30s. 30 sturdy sticks to act as like a tripod, I guess, for the cauldron. Or is it going to be there's two standing up and then The second one is lengthwise. I guess we'll see. Okay, yeah, there's two standing up. And then this third one's gonna be lengthwise. Here we go, in the cauldron. Hey, nice. Okay. I can cook here too. Thanks so much for helping. You're welcome. After eating food and sleep, I suppose the next most important thing is to be able to sit and relax properly. Having built a couple of proper benches here for the campfire. Here, look, a few planks here. They're both ideal for the job. Grab them, sit them on top of the bits of wood or any side of the fire, and then we'll have a really lovely pair of benches. And on my head, agents can do the benches sorted. Just haven't got so far, I've actually done them. You're here to help me. Yes, we're a gem of all trades. Okay, apparently, where are the planks? Oh, he gave them to us. Okay. It's like, we have to go find these planks of wood. They're already here. Inventory. Okay. Nice. We built one bench. Let's go back over. I suppose he's expecting a few guests if he's building two benches like this. We could have three or four people could sit comfortably on each. Which is done. Probably now we can sit soft on the benches and stare thoughtfully into the campfire. Cozy. Think clearly again. I need to contact 888. Tell them what's happened. I work for them after all. They went for the news. It's a vengeful balloon. And this thing have disappeared forever. After a letter, they're still prisoners. Can I ask for your help to raise situation and support for them? Right there on the bench should be nice, even surface for them. Right there on the bench should be a nice, even surface for them. Alright, so we're gonna write a report. We need to dismount for this. Yep, we can't write on horseback, apparently. We can build benches, but we can't write letters. So we're writing a report. Okay, actually, I put the stone with his butt perked in Nick's face. So very nice. Thanks, Lily. I just need to post it. And shoot, there's no mailbox without hearing the wilderness. Oh, do I do a closed door? And I suppose I should send a request to the post office. And maybe some saw mailbox here. Could you help me write that letter as well, Misha? Sure. Then I guess I'll have to deliver it to Derek, probably, in Silverglade. Alright, second letter done. Thanks again for your help with the writing. Let's take this letter to someone along with civilized to our post office. On the dark and silk green, he was at the post office. Fantastic. Take these to our attendant. Thanks in advance, Alicia. Okay, so we're bringing the letters to Nick and Silverblade. So, I guess it's called pickup, because that will be a little faster than running all the way from Dino Valley. Head over to Silverglade. April Brave Eagle. Oh, that's a cute horse. That's one of the magic horses. If I remember correctly, you can get it during like the winter holiday festival. There's like a bunch of like special magical horses that you can get during that time, but when the update comes around, maybe we'll do a little tour of the winter village. We'll take a look at the magical horses. We probably won't buy one because I don't have very many star coins, but we can look at them and admire them from afar. Alright, let's run over to Derek. Hey, Alicia, my name is Stone Bolt from Frozen Solid. Two letters, eh? One to AAE. Nice, I got some talk for you. Third was from us here at the post office. Exciting. Okay, while you're out adventuring the valley of the dinosaur. That's so cool. Next time there's also a mailbox at his camp there. If I'd have high enough reputation for us to be able to install a mailbox, and it's a legend. But of course, we can get something to sort out for him. Now, here's the post office HQ. He wants to split all the mail into incoming send the link to your boss to grab the camp, understood? Cool, okay, couldn't get my hair on either. Okay, so I think we'll stop here for now and we'll continue next time. Play together and we'll see if the request will be ready. If not, I suppose we'll continue helping Nick Stone ground out and we'll get those meal boxes sorted out for him. So, thank you so much for watching. I hope you have a lovely evening, night, morning, or afternoon, depending on when you watch this video. Until next time.